नमस्ते हाइडी हाउ आर यू।
Taki, how are you?
आई एम गुड थैंक यू। ओके देन लेट्स बिगिन टुडे सेशन। सिट इन एनी कंफर्टेबल पोज, क्लोज योर आईज, टेक अ डीप ब्रेथ इन, लॉन्ग एक्सहेल आउट। Inhale and then exhale. Now we'll chant three time all together. Inhale. Now join your hands together in front of your heart center. Bow your head down and then open your eyes while blinking. And namaste. So do you remember what did we learn day before yesterday?
It was about the alignment of the back bend and how you should breathe from your chest rather than your stomach in upward facing dog.
Yes, we talked about that. We talked about mobility, stability, and our back bend, right? So today we will talk about forward bend, that how it's supposed to happen. So before we get into forward bend, let's warm up ourselves, then we'll go further. Okay, stand up straight. Now inhale, raise your arms up over the head. Exhale, bend forward, hands on the floor. Inhale, halfway look up. And then exhale, jump back to Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, Urdhva Svanasana, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. And stay there. One, two, maybe you can pedal out your legs if you want. Three, bend your leg. Four, now bend your knees, jump forward for the halfway lookup, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, completely bend forward, lower your head down. Now inhale, all the way come up high. And then exhale, again bend forward. Now inhale, halfway look up. And then exhale, jump back to Chaturanga Dandasana. Now inhale, upward facing dog, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Exhale, downward facing dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana. And hold, one, two, three, four, and five. Now jump forward for the halfway look up. Exhale, completely bend down. Inhale, stretch your arms over the head. And then exhale, again bend forward. Now inhale, halfway look up. Now again, jump back to Chaturanga. Now upward facing dog. Now roll back on your toes for the downward facing dog. Now take your right leg up in the air. Stretch out, make your toes pointed. Exhale, step your right leg in between your both hands. Arms up for the warrior A. Push your back heel on the floor. Very nice. Exhale, hands on the floor. Again, step back to Chaturanga. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, roll back on your toes for the downward facing dog. Now stretch your left leg up in the air, all the way high. Yeah, easy. Exhale, left leg forward in between your both hands. Now arms up for the warrior A. Exhale, hands on the floor. Again, step back to Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. And hold here. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Now jump forward for the halfway look up. Now exhale, completely bend down. Now inhale for the chair pose, Utkatasana. Bend your knees. Now from here, join your hands together in front of your heart center. In front of your heart center, now hook your right elbow on your left knee. Now hook your right elbow on your left knee and then press your hand, twist your spine back. Look up high with every exhalation. Hold for three, two, one. Inhale again, back to the chair pose, Utkatasana. Exhale on the other side, twist your spine out and hold. One, two, three. Now inhale again, back to the center for the chair pose. Exhale, bend forward, hands on the floor. Inhale, halfway look up. And then exhale, jump back to Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. And then hold. One, two, three, four, five. Again, jump forward for the halfway look up. Exhale, completely bend down. Again, chair pose, Utkatasana, bend your knees. Now again, twist your spine, hook your right elbow on your left knee, and then look up high to the ceiling. Press. Now inhale, back to the center for the chair pose, Utkatasana. Exhale, on the other side, hook your left elbow on your right knee, twist your spine back, look up high to the ceiling. Now inhale, again back to the center. Now exhale, completely bend forward. Now grab your ankles with your both hands. Now inhale again, halfway look up. And then exhale, bend your elbows, lower your head down. And then stretch your spine, stretch your hips. Hold for three, two, one. Inhale, again, halfway look up. Now send your right leg back. And then hold here, and then sink your hips down. Keep that leg straight, very nice. Keep that leg straight. Hold, one, yes, high lunge. Two, three. Now exhale, hands on the floor. Again, step back to the plank. Now drop your knees down, chest down, and chin down on the floor. Inhale, swing forward for the cobra pose, Bhujangasana. Exhale, roll back on your toes for the downward facing dog. Now bend your knees, jump forward for the halfway look up. Now exhale, again completely bend down. Inhale for the chair pose, Utkatasana. And then stay there for three, two, one. Exhale again, bend forward. Now hold on your ankles, completely bend down. Now stretch your legs, stretch your hips together. Now from here, send your left leg back for the high lunge. And then stretch your arms up over the head. Keep that leg straight, back leg straight. Hold and sink your hips down. Exhale, send your, now place your hands down. Now step your right leg back for the plank. Then drop your knees down, chest down, and chin down on the floor. Inhale, swing forward for the cobra pose, Bhujangasana. And then exhale, roll back on your toes for downward facing dog. And hold, five. Pedal out your legs one by one if you want. Two, three, four, five. Jump forward for the half pillow cup. Exhale, completely bend down. Now inhale for the chair pose, Utkatasana. And then exhale, Samasthiti. Now from here, open your legs out, hip width apart, like this. Just keep your legs open, hip width apart. Okay. Now, after this, just grab your elbows together with your both hands. Make sure your spine is straight. Now from here, we will rapidly move for the 10 times. Like inhale, halfway look up, exhale, completely down. Inhale, and then exhale down. Inhale again high, exhale, completely down. Okay, so we'll do this for the 10 times.
Mm-hmm.
One, just keep on moving. Two, see your hands and your head. This would go together up and down. Two, your hands should be right beside your hips. Sorry, right beside your ears. Hands would be, yeah, beside your ears. Okay. And then reach up high, exhale completely down. Good job. And give your body nice jerk and push. One, keep on moving. Two, yeah, go a little faster, increase the pace of that movement. Four, move, forcefully exhale and down. Five, yes, increase that pace. Six, seven, try to touch your hands on your feet. Eight, nine, 10, for the last 10 more times. One, forcefully exhale right there. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Now completely bend forward and hold on your big toes. Inhale, halfway look up, spine straight. And then bend your elbows, lower your head down. Yeah, do not make any hump on your back. Just try to bend forward from your pelvic girdle, lengthening your spine. Touch your abdomen on your thighs. Try to touch your abdomen on your thighs. Yes, and then hold. One, two, and three. Now release your hips down and rest here. Sorry. Okay, now we will talk about the alignment of the forward bend.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. See, what is the main purpose of the forward bend? Like, in which muscle do we feel that is stretched?
The back.
On the back. We can also call it the posterior group of muscles. Whichever muscle we have got behind, like on our butts, on our lower back, on our thoracic region, or hamstring, back of knee, and calf, they all are should be stretched when we are doing forward bend.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And we can also say the extension of this posterior group of muscles and contraction of your frontal group of muscles. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
See, and I have a question for you.
Mm-hmm.
Which forward bend that you feel more comfortable or more intense? Seated forward bend or standing forward bend? We have two type of forward bends.
Sorry, could you say that again?
Yeah, we do have two types of forward bend, standing forward bend and seated forward bend. Which one you mm-hmm. feel more effective or more intense?
The seated one.
The seated one is intense.
Mm-hmm.
That's very hard to get.
To get all the way down. Yeah.
Yes. Because why does this happen? Do you have any idea?
Not sure.
Mm-mm. But you must have some idea. Okay, let me tell you. In this standing forward bend, if you see standing forward bend, we have very short center of the gravity, right? The mm-hmm. foundation is our only our feet. But in this mm-hmm. seated forward bend, that the center of the gravity is divided into different segments.
Okay.
If you talk about our leg, that is completely flat on the floor, right? And then if we talk about the center of the gravity, it cannot be defined, right? It's very hard mm-hmm. to get there.
Mm-hmm.
So your hip does have also the body weight. The gravity is also pulling your hips down. Your knees also pulled down by your gravity, and your heels are also being pulled down, right? So at that time, we cannot easily find the center of the gravity, and that center of the gravity is very wide and very broad. Okay, but when we are talking about the standing forward bend, at the time the center of the gravity is very easy to find.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So in order to make that center of the gravity, like make it easy to understand the center of the gravity, in the standing, you can easily by pushing your heels down. Once you push your heels down, you can easily find the center of the gravity, or somewhere in between your heel and your toes. In the standing, you can easily find the gravity.
Mm-hmm.
So the center of the gravity that plays a major role in your flexibility.
Mm-hmm.
If you're working out on your hamstring, if you're working out on your lower back, on your hip, at the time, that gravity helps us to understand how we are going to pull that or how we are going to extend.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And one more thing about this forward bend. See, we can easily feel that stretch in the forward bend on our hamstring. It's necessary, like it's very simple. Like whenever you're bending forward, you will have a stretch on your hamstring. It's very simple. Mm-hmm. But what about your lower back? What about your butt? You may have found many people like they are straight with their legs, but when they bend forward, they make big hump on their back,
mm-hmm.
right? They make big round on their back. So that happens because of that ultimate stiffness in between your lower back on your butt and your hamstring. Because ultimately they all are connected to each other. The lower back is also connected to your butt, and your butt's muscles are also connected to your hamstring somewhere. So that is why in the forward bend, we can easily feel that stretch on our hamstring. But when it comes to your lower back, your butt, we don't usually feel that stretch right there in the forward mm-hmm. bend. Okay. So first we are going to work on our lower back. Then we will move further to our hips. After that, which is very simple or easy, that is your hamstring, to have that stretch, then we'll work out on our hamstring.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So very mm-hmm. first, we are going to work on our spine. You may have also heard whenever we do forward bend, the instructor, they say, keep your spine straight, look front, your head should not be dropped down.
Mm-hmm.
Once you drop your head down, you will make hump on your back. So that should be released. Okay, that should be straight. Thoracic and lower back, they should be all the time straight. Okay, so here we are going to bring that enough consciousness so that we can first stretch our lower back. After that, we will stretch our hips. After that, we will stretch our hamstring.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so just please stand up straight. Let's do that. Forward bend. Okay, just wait for a while. Okay, when we do forward bend, first we will do it wrong, then we'll make it right.
Okay.
Okay, just completely bend down into forward bend. So where are you feeling stretch right now?
In the backs of my legs.
On the back of your leg.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and where else?
Nowhere else. My calves and my backs of my thighs.
Yes. So basically we usually have the stretch on our hamstring, but in the beginning we are going to stretch our lower back, after that hips, then at the end we will come to our hamstring. Okay. So this is your okay. So after this, just slightly bend your knees and then bring the chest up, keeping your spine straight, and then make a couple of finger with your both hands. Slightly bend your knees, make a couple of finger with your both hands. And then walk your hands forward. Okay. Your hands are coming close to your ears now. Earlier it was drop down. Now your hands are moving forward. Your hands are coming close to your ears. And keep walking your hands forward. And try to shift your body weight onto your toes. But do not leave that press from your heels. Okay. Do not leave that push from your heels. Keep pushing your heels and your toes together on the floor into your mat and keep crawling your hands forward without shifting your body weight. Your body weight should not be shifted to your hands. Your hands are only for the slight support. Yes. Move your hips back. Your hips should be right above your heels. It will not move forward like this in the downward facing dog. Okay. Just keep crawling your hands like this, but without walking. Keep crawling. Look front in between your hands. Now you will feel that sensation on your legs. Are you feeling that?
Yeah.
Okay. So after this, just keep walking and then feel that stretch on your hip joint, in your butts, glutes maximus, minimus together. Just keep walking, reach your hips high, reach your tailbone high, and then you will have slight stretch on your sideways. Okay, yeah. On your lower back too. And then still, see, now you won't have that stretch on your hamstring. There will be very less stretch. But once you stay here in this position, remain this position as it is. After this, now try to extend your legs. Try to straighten your legs.
Uh-huh.
Your hip is moving forward. Move your hips back. Move your hips back, Heidi. Yes, move your hips back, right above your heels. Now walk forward with your hands. You're not actually walking. You're just moving from your fingertips. Yes, now extend your legs. Try to extend your legs.
They're extended.
Yeah, extend it. And then move your hips slightly more back. Move your hips slightly more back. Yes. Now stay here and pull your abdomen in so that your lower back gets straight too. Now stay here for a few more counts. 5, 4, 3. Back to your feet. Walk your hands. Up high. Yeah, take your arms up over the head. Yeah, just all the way come up. Now exhale, release down.
Sorry?
So did you understand? Yeah, now release down, release your hands. It is word in the beginning, we need to stretch only on our lower back. After that, we move further to our hips. At the end, we will stretch our hamstring. Okay.
Could you repeat that all? Because you broke up after you said put your hands above your head. You froze.
Did you say Heidi? I could not understand. I did not hear you.
Your camera froze and your voice froze when you said put your hands above your head, so I didn't hear any of that, sorry.
Hi, Heidi.
Hello.
What did you just say?
I said that I didn't hear anything you said after you said raise your hands above your head because it broke up the connection.
No. I said, did you all understand the thing that we did? We'll have a stretch in the beginning on our lumbar region, then hips. After that, we'll move to our hamstring. So did you understand that how we are going to stretch our lower back?
I think so, yeah.
Okay. So we do have another thing we can modify or we can make variation into this forward bend. Okay. You can use a block too. See, once you get the height from the floor, it will be very easy to get to the posture and deepen the posture. So as you are here in the forward bend, you will drag that block out forward. See, I'm not shifting my body weight onto my hands. I'm just, my body weight remains on my feet, but I'm just stretching my hands forward. So that's why my block is dragged forward. Okay, just drag your blocks forward, 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 forward. Now you will have nice extension on your lower back and the sideways together. Okay, if it's getting too intense on your hamstring, you can slightly bend your knees and then stretch your arms forward, 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 forward. But still, the body weight remains on your heels, on your feet. Okay, so you have to stay here like this. So as long as you want, you can hold. Or what else you can do? If you have got chair nearby you or in front, you can use the chair and then stretch your hips back back, and then hold the position like this.
Mm-hmm.
So how do we enter into this pose? See, first, your whole entire body will be in one straight line. But in the beginning, when you're bending forward, when you're entering into the posture, you will first move your hips back. Mm-hmm. Okay, first your hips moves back away from the center line of your body. Okay, first you move your hips back, and then you bend forward into 90 degree angle. Okay, so once you bend further than the 90 degree angle or mm-hmm. like below than the 90 degree angle, then you will shift your body weight on your feet.
Okay.
See, earlier like this. Yeah. Now my body is shifted on my toes. Earlier mm-hmm. it was completely on my heels. Now it's shifted on my toes and heels together. Now after that, you can release your hands on the floor. Now you will again inhale. Now while exhaling, first touch your abdomen on your thighs. Then try to touch your chest on your knees. And then look front, elevate high. And while exhaling, push down. And look front in between your hands. If you drop your head down, you will make hum. But if you look front, then it will be easy to be straight up with your lower back.
Yeah, that makes more sense.
Okay. So one more tendency we have in this in our muscle that does not stretch from the origin point. It always stretch from the insertion point. Okay. So if you talk about hamstring stretch, so where do you feel that maximum stretch in the hamstring? At the end of the insertion point, right? On the back of a knee.
Mm-hmm.
So that insertion point, we don't feel stretch on our origin point. Do you feel that?
How do you spell those two words that you just said?
That origin point, O-R-I-G-N-G-I-N.
O-R-I.
G.
Say that again, sorry.
G. G.
G.
E. G-I-N.
Okay.
Origin and insertion. I N S E R.
Yeah.
T I U N.
Okay, cool. Thank you.
Yeah, this is your insertion point and origin point. Mm-hmm. So we usually have that, like, if you're talking about any muscle, we will have always stretch on the insertion point.
Okay,
so that is why we usually have that stretch only on a hamstring, like on the back of your knee, not mm-hmm. on the middle of the hamstring or on the top of the hamstring. Okay, so the same thing happens in your lower back. We usually have that stretch on that, you know, bottom of your lower back, not on the upper spine. And the same thing happens to your hips. It does not stretch from the top, it stretches from the end.
Okay.
So this is all for the forward bend, and we have adjustment too. Let's suppose somebody has got kyphosis on their lower back, sorry, on their thoracic region. Their shoulders are moved forward like this and they are making hump. Okay, so how they are going to do this back bend or this forward bend? They can interlock their fingers behind their back so that their spine gets straight or slight arch. Then okay. They will bend forward completely down with a straight leg. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So what else they can do? They will use the strap. Like they will make the small loop
mm-hmm.
according to that shoulder width apart. Okay. And that after that, they will adjust that loop on their hands like this.
Mm-hmm.
On their elbows. And then they will push their hands forward and they will completely bend down with a straight arm. Sorry, with a straight spine, and then mm-hmm. bend forward and hold. Okay.
Okay.
And what is the tendency of your body? Like whenever you bend forward, how does your leg rotate? Do they rotate inward or outward?
Sorry, say that again.
Whenever we do forward bend, how mm-hmm. our legs rotate, do they rotate inward or outward?
Inward?
Yes, see, whenever we're doing forward bend, our legs will start to rotate inward. And mm-hmm. whenever we are doing back bend, our legs will start to rotate outward automatically. It's a mm-hmm. पे दिस इज द टेंडेंसी ऑफ आवर फीट. आवर टोज डायरेक्टली इन्फ्लुएंसेस आवर हिप जॉइंट. इफ यू आर रोटेटिंग आवर लेग्स इनवर्ड दैट इज कॉल्ड फ्लेक्शन ऑफ योर हिप्स. इफ आवर लेग्स आर रोटेटिंग आउटवर्ड दैट इज कॉल्ड एक्सटेंशन ऑफ आवर हिप्स.
ओके,
एक्सटेंशन ऑफ द पेल्विक बोन.
Okay.
Okay, let's do this forward bend once again. Mm-hmm. Okay, now stretch your arms up over the head. Now first push your hips back. Push your hips back away from your body. Very nice. And then keeping your spine straight, bend forward, bend forward, bend forward from your hip joint. Very nice. And first touch your abdomen on your thighs. Now move your hips back, back to the center. Now come back to the center, center, center. Your hips, now move your hips forward to the center line of your body. Yeah. And now bend completely down from your hip joint. Now touch your abdomen on your thighs. Right? Mm-hmm. Now drop your chest on your knees. Look front, keep looking forward in between your feet. And then completely bend down once you feel comfortable, once you feel like your spine is straight. Yes, either you can grab your heel, and then completely bend forward. Or if it is getting too intense, you can slightly bend your knees to sustain that stretch on your hip joint. Okay. See, the purpose is to have your spine straight and your extension of your hip joint. Okay. So do not just feel that stretch only on your hamstring. We have to first stretch. We have to create a space in between the vertebra, then your butts, at the end, your hamstring.
Okay.
So do you have any question about this forward bend? You may ask.
I don't think so, no. I think it's all clear.
Okay. So what are the warm-up for this forward bend?
You could do cat-cow to flex the spine.
Yeah, to the flex the spine. And see, when you're bending forward, that is called flexion of your spine or flexion of the vertebra or spinal cord. When you're doing back bend, that is your extension of your spine. Okay. So the flexion extension we can do in the cobra pose, and we can do high lunges in the high lunges, right? But in the high lunges, we don't have stretch on the hamstring. Okay, so our high lunge is avoided. Our high lunge we're going to do as a warm up. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So, what we are going to do?
Cat and cow for the extension and flexion, and then the high lunges. Mm-hmm.
Not high lunges.
No, not the high lunges.
Yeah. See, do the high lunges, then you will understand.
Now.
Come up in the high lunge. Yeah. So this is your high lunge. Where are you feeling that stretch?
Oh, in the hamstring. Yeah. Okay.
So no, no, no. See, it's fine. It's fine. Yeah. This was warrior A. Again, come up. This was warrior A. You did just now. This is your high lunge. No, now this is your high lunge. Lift your back leg. This is your high lunge. Okay. You will have a stretch over here.
Yeah.
On your back leg.
Yeah.
Not the back leg. Over here on your hip flexors. Okay. So we have less stretch on our back of the knee or hamstring. Okay. Mm-hmm. In the high lunge, we have a lot of stretch only on our hip flexors, not on our hamstring. Okay. So either we can do triangle pose, Trikonasana.
It's
good for the hamstring stretch. We can do forward bend, like Padangusthanasana. Or Padasthasana, in which we keep our hands underneath our feet. And what else you can do? You can do wide leg forward bend.
Mm-hmm.
wide leg forward bend, this one, in which our legs are widened apart, and then you bend forward like this. So this is a wide leg forward bend. You can do this pyramid pose. In this, we are also having the stretch. We can do Padmasana, like grabbing our toes, extending our feet forward. And almost all sitting poses, like Paschimottanasana, Janusirsasana. So these are all hamstring stretches.
So you want to do those and before you do the forward bend?
Yes. So these are the preparation. If you want to go deep into the posture. And if you want to make it more intense, or you want to deepen, more deepen into the posture, you can like take the support of the partner or the wall, or that is your, you know, kind of modify version. Okay, we'll modify the pose. How are you going to do? Let's suppose we are doing forward bend like this. Okay, you're doing forward bend like this, and the other person will come behind you. And let's suppose you are here like this, and the other person will come behind you and touch your tailbone and his tailbone together.
Okay.
After this, completely bend down on you and then grab your toes from behind. Okay, that will be very intense, and that is your like, that will be your optimal level of the posture.
Okay.
So that's how you can do this.
That's cool.
And if you are going too much, you know, deepen into the posture, you will have also like problems. We do have problems too. Like sacroiliac joint pain, that usually happens when you are, you know, too much flexible. When you're too much flexible in the forward bend, so we do have sacroiliac joint pain too.
Okay.
Because see, when you're bending too much forward, now your vertebra will start to create the space. Once it start to create the space, you will have that, you know, synovial fluid that will start to come out. That is your fuel kind of. Fuel kind of in your spinal cord or in your joint. When it comes out from its place, then it will start to pinch your nerve. That will give you a lot of pain. Okay. So the maximum forward, like whoever do forward bend, they do have problems too. Okay. So this is your extended level. When you are going too much forward, when you are doing forward bend excessively, you will definitely have problem too. Okay. So one more thing in the forward bend, let's suppose our legs are here, our hips are here. I'm bending forward, my hips, now I don't have space to getting more down, right? Once, let's suppose I'm completely flexible. My muscles extension is still here. Now I'm extending till here. Now I cannot go further than this because my muscles does not have that, like it's already flexible. Now it cannot go further than this. But now still people, they want to extend it more further, right? So they cannot extend further from their muscles. But now what they will try to do, they will try to bend forward from their bones, okay, from their pelvic girdle. Now let's suppose I am completely bent down, I cannot go further than this, and the other person is pushing me down because I'm not feeling any stretch. So he's going to push me down. Now my tailbone, which is stable, my low back, which is stable, now it will start to work. It does have a stability. When he's going to push me down, maybe my tailbone will start to crack. That may come out. So that is your sacroiliac joint pain when we do have cracks in between that joint. Okay, we do have to care about it too.
Okay.
So what did you understand?
Not to push yourself too far. Once you've reached your limit and you begin to not stretch your muscles anymore, you might injure your bones and cause like tailbone cracks and stuff like that.
Yes. So that's also we have to understand, and we are not going to go so far.
Yeah.
Okay. So if you're already flexible, that is fine, but no need to go.
If not,
and no need to make somebody to push us. Okay. So what are the benefits of these forward bends? What do you feel like?
Sorry, say that again.
What are the benefits of the forward bends?
Increased hamstring flexibility.
Except flexibility.
I'm not sure.
Okay, so it's very normal, like the blood flow that you start to come out of your head. Like, so that comes to your head and it reduces fat. If you're doing bending forward, see, your reduction of your fat, that happens when you're contracting that particular muscles. Okay, if you're just doing forward bend, you just keep on contracting, it will not reduce. It will not reduce because you have to extend that muscle too. You have to warm up that muscle too, or that fat, whatever is there. Okay, first they have to do back bend, then forward bend. After that, you will have results, like better results. But if you're doing forward bend only, you're not back, you're not extending that that particular region fat, you will not lose that fat.
Okay.
So what I mean, when you're bending forward, you're contracting this part of the muscle or this part of fat, but you're extending your back portion. Okay. Now, what we have to do, we have to do it opposite. Now we'll have to do back bend. Now it's the extension of your abdomen, contraction of your lower back. Okay. So that's we have to do if somebody wants to lose that fat. Okay. Yeah, proportionally they have to do it on the like both sides together.
Yeah,
anything else that you want to ask?
No, I think that's good.
Okay, then let's finish today's session then. Now sit in any comfortable pose. Close your eyes. Now we will chant one Om followed by three Shanti together. Take a deep breath in. Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. Now join your hands together in front of your heart center. Bow your head down. Now open your eyes while blinking. And namaste.
Namaste.
Okay, Aditi ji, enjoy your day.
You too.
See you tomorrow. Bye bye.
You're
welcome.